and Thomas got me lit. I'ma need a sentimental man or woman to pump me up. Feeling fussy, walking in my Balenciessies, trying to bring out the fabulous. Cause I give a fuck way too much. I'ma need like two shots in my cup. Wanna get
make a run for shoddy. Call him Ed Sheeran, he in love with my body. Get into it, yo. Pop out with a truck, huh. Get into it, yo. If you go to church, I said get into it, yo. I just shit gotta put up, fuck it, get into it, yo. And I said I just gotta walk, get into it.
Potra!
Preach that to me, is escape.
Imagine hurting the girl that God sent to heal you. Enjoy that loss.
A day in my life, Coachella day one. I woke up, I did my makeup. I love this time-lapse feature because you can choose how fast or how slow you want the time-lapse to be, and it really captured a lot more movement. I got to the festival. I used the Material You feature to match my outfit with my phone aesthetic by taking a picture of my outfit, putting it in my wallpaper, and then it matches the style of my widgets on my phone to my outfit for the day. Then I went to go see the Marías, and I got to use my ultra-wide selfie to capture not only myself, but the crowd and the Marías performing all in one photo. I went to interview Maria from the Marías on the Fashion Sense, but it was so loud I could barely hear her. I used my speech enhancement feature to make sure I captured all of her answers, and it worked out perfectly.
Do you think what you wear on stage encapsulates your everyday fashion?
I like level up a little bit for the stage.
I used night sight mode to take this amazing picture of Maria. It came out perfect. And that's how I ended off my Coachella day one.
Yeah, big, hey, barely get out.
Ready with me to go to the Miami Open. I was gonna wear a tennis skirt, but honestly, I've never been to a tennis match, so I really don't know what people wear, and I do not want to be mistaken for one of the players. I think I'm gonna try the satin skirt. Super cute, but I think it might be too dressy. This might have just made it even dressier. But I feel like I feel in it. It's super cute. It's really hot out. I don't know. Gonna pair it with these gold, like, hoop things. Actually, I went on live and they definitely told me that I was too overdressed, so I put this dress on and I feel like it's perfect for the occasion. I pair it with this Gucci fanny pack and some white sandals.
Next up, the style switcheroo. A model needs to master the quick change.
All right, it's about damn time.
In a minute, I'ma need a sentimental man or woman to pump me up. Feeling fussy, walking in my Balenciessies, trying to bring out the fabulous. Cause I give a fuck way too much. I'ma need like two shots in
my... Saw someone else do this and wanted to give it a try. This is what 5'6 and 235 pounds looks like. Your turn.
I know you told your friend you're not okay. And tell me what's wrong and why you never said you felt that way. Guess you're trying to stay strong and fake a smile until I look away. But I've known you too long, it hurts to watch your blue eyes fade to gray. As you fade away, as you fade away.
Yeah, I'm about to fade away. Cause every time I wake up, I feel like it's Monday.
This is how I got the confidence to wear this at 9 a.m. knowing damn well I'd be overdressed. Reminder 1. You're irrelevant. Nothing you do actually matters. So if you're gonna go out with a bang. And maybe your fit will make you relevant. Reminder 2. The girls that get it, get it. If you don't vibe with the fit, you probably won't vibe with me. So at least I'm staying true to my palate with what to eat and serve. Reminder 3. That girl wasn't born. She was created. So instead of picking apart your outfit, realize that confidence is the best thing you can wear. Even if you have to fake it. Because eventually, you will make it.
To all my other ladies with this cute little second stomach that's in between our boobs and our actual stomach, we have no idea where it comes from. It's from spending years of your life sucking in your stomach. This isn't your stomach, it's your diaphragm muscle, and you've accidentally grown it. Let me show you. So women are socially conditioned to walk around sucking in our stomachs all the time, so we look super small and cute, but here is the issue with that. When we inhale, this muscle contracts, it gets bigger, and when we exhale, this muscle relaxes, it gets smaller. But when you're not taking full and deep breaths, you're keeping this muscle contracted, therefore growing it. But fortunately, there's a very simple solution to this. Just let that shit hang, baby. Stop walking around like this. No one cares. Just let it rip. I'm so hot, you're so hot, let's kiss.
So it's really come to my attention that it's still not really normalized for a woman, a thick woman, to be sitting down while showing her stomach. So I'm just gonna leave this here. For whoever needs it. I know some days I do. See, the thing is, I look like this. And I know there's gonna be a lot of, like, cis men in the comments. You know the drill. But the thing is, I look like this and I still get dick anytime I want, you know? So, baby girl, we're doing okay.
I'll scream at you louder. Louder, 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 louder.
My bitch got a body like Aldo. What up, dog? I'm not.
My body is shaped like a rectangle. Some people are shaped like a triangle, a square, a quadrangle, a circle. And we all have beautiful different shapes in the family of geometry. So do not worry, do not stress.
Just like a flower garden,
roses and sunflowers are different shapes. They look nothing alike, but they're both very beautiful on their own. Just like you, okay?